a horse. Hey, thanks, Dusty.
Hey, Hoss, it's Roundup. Sure gonna beat all, ain't it?
Yeah, it is, Jamie.
Hey, Jamie, why don't you just take his rifles in the house? Keep sure the muzzles up.
All right.
Well, he's sure gonna be disappointed if Paul don't let him go, ain't he?
Well, he sure is. That's all he's talking about.
Jamie.
Huh?
You sound tired.
Oh, no, sir, not a bit. But I could eat a horse.
Well, let's hope Hop Singh comes up with something more civilized than that. I rode over to Willow Branch School today.
Yes, sir?
And Mrs. Aiken says you can start tomorrow.
You mean school?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Mr. Carhart, I can't do it. The roundup starts in a couple of days, and I'll be working here with Joe and Haas and everybody, aren't I?
No, I'm afraid not, Jamie.
I don't want to go to school. I don't want to.
Going to school?
No, sir. That's what I came to talk to you about. I don't want to go. I mean, it's awful hard riding back and forth to Virginia City every day.
Well, that's been changed. All the children in this area will be going to the Willow Branch School.
Same difference.
Quite. Willow Branch is 2 miles closer. And what you've told us, you didn't get too much schooling when you were traveling around the country with your father.
Well, I got enough, Mr. Cartwright. I mean, I looked after myself after my pa died, and I was doing all right.
Jamie, sit down. Have you decided what you want to be when you grow up?
Well, I was kind of hoping to be a cattleman.
Well, good.
And I got all the learning I need for that.
Huh? What if you're going to run a place of your own? You're going to have to be able to handle all this and much more.
Well, I could read real good. And I can add all the sums I'd ever have to know.
Want to take a minute to find out? I mean, just to be sure.
Sure, you'll see.
All right. Now, add these up. 67, 41, and 18.
Is that all?
Yeah.
126.
That's very good. And your head, too.
Yeah, and I can do harder ones than that.
Now, can you multiply and divide?
Yeah, I can. Not as fast.
Hmm. Go ahead.
No, they're mostly big words.
Yeah, Mr. Gifford is offering to sell me a piece of his property. 1 mile by 2 miles. Now, the fair price for that kind of property would be about $8 an acre. He's asking $11,500. Do you think I ought to buy it?
Hey, follow this over, will you? We got an awful lot of things to take care of. Just take a look. I'm not too sure about this one.
I can't do it. But I could pick it up in no time, Mr. Cartwright, working here with you. You could teach me.
Well, I can't promise I'll always be available when you need me, Jamie. Like now. You know, we got roundup business to do. And Mrs. Hagen will teach you history and spelling and a lot of things you ought to know.
Why tomorrow? Why? I mean, why can't I go after the roundup?
Because school's already started. It took some persuading to get Mrs. Hagen and the board to let you start this late. And I want you to go. Jamie, there'll be other roundups. See you this afternoon, then.
Yes.
If you make it your business to get along with me, young man, you'll find I'm fair. Firm, but fair.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, you were tardy this morning.
Well, yes, but Mr. Cartwright had to show
me. Oh, I don't believe Mr. Cartwright is a student in this school. However, I'm willing to overlook it this time, but you bear that in mind now if it should happen again.
Yes, ma'am.
Now take a seat in the fifth grade. In the cloakroom. You should know that. All right, that's enough.
Oh, hey, Joe.
What does Hillier want this time?
He wants to know how we're going to work out the split up on the unbranded cast.
Oh, for Pete's sake. Hello, Jamie. Well, how was school today?
It was terrible. This old Mrs. Hagen's
all... I want to hear all about it in just a minute. When will he be here?
I'd say in about 5 minutes. He's coming in a buggy with another man.
We have to have this argument every fall.
He's hopping mad.
All right.
Hmm.
I think I'll go handy.
Yeah. Oh, sure. Be careful.
He's talking lawsuit if we don't change the operation from last year.
Well, why don't we let him brand all the cabs?
Well, I think that's what Hillier has in mind.
Mr. Cartwright?
What?
Is it all right if I take this gun?
No, not that one. Nothing special. We're going to get it in writing, this. I tell you, if you don't have everything in writing with that, brother, you'll just take everything.
Figured Elsie Haynes won.
Oh, yeah, too bad. Well, got to get back for it. I just couldn't make it.
Oh, I understand.
Well, the roundup go all right?
Yeah, it went fine. We got the south part done. Now we got to ride up north and get that finished. How you getting along, Miss Hagen?
All right, I guess.
No problems?
Nothing I can't handle.
Good.
Where's Joe?
Oh, he rode off into town. Going to get the cattle quotations.
Hey, Paul. Here's something you might ought to take a look at. Hey, how's the spelling going, Jamie?
C-O-N-S-C-I-O-U-S. Conscious.
Hey, very good, buddy.
I'll tell you, no rest for the weary.
Oh, Jamie, Dusty's outside.
Hi, Dusty.
Hey there, Jamie. Tell me about school.
I hate it.
What's wrong?
Oh, everything. The reading, the spelling, the teacher. I'm in with a bunch of little kids. Dusty, what if I was to tell you I was in a lot of trouble?
A lot of trouble? What's the market?
It's down.
Joe, I'll be there. Did you think that kid still wants to fight you?
Well, yeah, but I don't think it'll bother me anymore.
Joe!
I'm seeing!
Oh, good glory.
I don't know.
Do you know if anybody took it?
No.
Just put my gun in the rack and the piece fell right off.
Jamie, do you know anything about this?
No, sir.
You sure?
Yes, sir.
Concerned, Paul, it'd be a big mistake to sell into the Clarendon market.
I don't think we have any choice. What do you think, Pop? Hey, Pop.
Sorry.
What is it, Jamie?
Yeah. Just don't know what to do about it. I sure don't like to think he lied to me.
When was the last time you handled that rifle?
A couple of months ago.
Well, there was nothing wrong with the gun then. None of us have touched it since.
Just hit him up with it.
Well, you just can't accuse him and punish him. Well, there's no proof. Sometimes the way you handle something is so important. I just don't know how to handle this. I can't just let it pass. That wouldn't be right. Sure wouldn't do Jamie any good.
Well, for my money, there ain't that much wrong with him, no.
Well, let's get back to this.
Hi, Jamie.
Good morning, Joe.
Take this into the gunsmith, see if he can fix it.
It's too bad.
Yeah, Pa's pretty upset about it. You see this?
To Benjamin Cartwright with esteem and appreciation.
And he got the right from the State Cattlemen's Association. Helped found it. He's president of it for 2 years. It's not really the rifle that means anything to him. It's the thought behind it, the men, what they thought of him. I'd like to find out how it happened.
Joe,
Yeah?
I gotta get to school.
Have a good day.
Yeah, but I never said uncle.
Uncle for you.
And I'm not going back to school anymore.
Well, now, wait a minute, young man.
I can't! And I broke your gun, too. I didn't mean to.
I never thought you did.
It was a fool thing to do. I just up and took it.
You knew that you shouldn't.
Yes, sir.
Then you lied to me.
Yes, sir, I did.
Well, you owned up to it, and that's right and proper. And I suppose I could just forget about it. But this is too important a matter just to forget about.
George, you'll start sawing wood. About 4 cords ought to do it. Now, about that fight.
Now, you wait a minute. I owned up to that darn old gun of yours, and that's all you're gonna get.
City wired me back that as of yesterday, Jamie was there working at Timmons's livery stable. You want me to go fetch him back?
He doesn't want to come back. Ah, that wouldn't be such a good idea.
Probably not. He'd more than likely just go away again anyway.
You know, it should be one of us.
Yeah, I think this is something I have to do.
We'll take care of the roundup you get back.
Yeah, I'll join you as soon as I can.
Talk me into coming back. Well, you're wasting your time.
Jamie, what's wrong? Didn't we treat you well?
Oh, sure. You fed me, put a roof over me, took care of me. You'd do the same for a dog you'd pick up.
Where'd you get that
idea? It's the truth. You never paid me any more mind than you had to.
Jamie, I've been busy. Maybe I didn't pay enough attention to you, I admit that.
Yeah, well, from now on, you don't have to worry anything about me at all.
Did it ever occur to you that I might want to bother? Now, look, I know you've been having some problems.
You're darn right. Sitting with a bunch of little kids. That old teacher picking on me. Darn Frank Snyder just pushing and itching to fight me. Well, all that was your idea, not mine.
Well, Jamie, it was for your good.
I can decide what's for my own good, and from now on, I'm going to. I can talk this way now because you don't have a hold on me, not one particle. And I'm not going to cut your darn wood.
Now, look, you don't have to yell.
Yell about anything. Just take it easy.
Did you ever tell me you had any problems?
I tried.
Not hard enough. Are you afraid of me?
I was, kinda, but not anymore.
Jamie, I want you to come back. We all do. You'll have a...
You said that once before. You'll have a nice home with us, Jamie. We'll be like a family to you, you said. Well, I tried it, and I don't like it. You don't have anything there I want.
I think we do. These things take time, Jamie. Come on back, we'll work this.
I'm not going back, and you can't make me. Now that's all I gotta say.
Say this. Being on your own has a certain advantage. You don't have to worry about anybody else, just yourself and your own problems. And as long as you do it, that's all you'll ever worry about. And believe me, you're well on the way to that. Now, I didn't pick my sons. They were born to me. But I did pick you. I didn't have to, but I did. You might consider that a point in your favor. Hoss and Joe and I want you to be a part of our family. Now, if you are a part of our family, you're going to have to give up something. Worrying about yourself. You and your problems won't always be the center of attention because we have our problems, too.
Yeah.
And you may have to worry about them. Oh, if you do have a problem, don't whine and mumble and then start feeling sorry for yourself because nobody's turned around. I may be busy or just plumb tired, so speak up. To my certain knowledge, we don't have a single mind reader on the Ponderosa. You have a wealth of affection to give you, respect and understanding, but you have to give them back. They're all there, but they're on a two-way street. And if you come back, and I sure hope you do, because I want you to, I'm going to treat you exactly as I treat one of my own sons. Which means that sometimes I'll tell you to do things that you won't like. Because I know more than you do. I'm older. It's as simple as that. I try to be fair. But sometimes I make mistakes, so you might as well expect them because I'm also human. Now, so far, I don't think I've been unfair. So, if you decide to come back, the woodcutting stands. You'll just have to accept that discipline voluntarily. Along with everything else we have to give you. You think about it, Jamie. The door will be wide open.
Anymore tonight.
I suppose you're right. I guess what worked for Hoss and Joe. Well, we tried. I'll join the round in the morning.
I thought I'd just as well get started.
Yeah, fine. Hop Singh's got you up in the warming oven. Whenever you're ready.
Pretty sure that another day ought to do it.
Whispers?
Well, just a couple, but they were better yesterday.
Hard work will do it every time
you get. Hey, certificate.
Hey, congratulations. Hey, yeah, for excellence in arithmetic. Very good.
Yeah, I got a frat and them sums faster than anybody else. A whole lot faster.
Well, that's marvelous.
That's great.
Just great. Well, how do you like school now, eh?
I hate it.
Come on.
I hate it.
I heard you. You're getting used to it.
Oh, I never did.